12 people, including a police officer, killed in Thousand Oaks, California. The suspect is 28-year-old Ian David Long. He is dead, former Marine. Joining us now to talk about this is Bill Zenfer, NBC News national correspondent. Always good to have you on. What do we know about Ian David Long this morning?
Well, we know a lot about this young man. At this point, we know that the 28-year-old was a military veteran, a corporal in the U.S. Marine Corps who served 5 years in the Marines from 2008 to 2013. That included a seven-month tour in Afghanistan from November of 2010 to June of 2011. We also know that he did have a history with authorities in Ventura County. Authorities were called out to his home last spring on a disturbing the peace complaint. He was said to be acting irrationally, and at that point, a mental health evaluation was done. But that evaluation showed that he did not meet the standard for an emergency psychiatric hold, and he was not determined to be a hazard to himself or to others. So he was on the radar of authorities out there, but Ian David Long nonetheless took this action, and at this point we know what happened and how it happened, but the question remains why it happened.
Do we know, you know, if he had a job, if he was living by himself, if he had family around, any kind of loved one who he was living with?
Yeah, he was living with his mother in Newberry Park, California. As for a job, you know, that is a sketchy detail. He may have had some jobs. He may have gone from job to job. He reportedly was trying to go back to college. So it was, you know, obviously a young man who was still searching for direction in life. And but what prompted him to turn this way remains to be seen. There are those who say that that his mother knew he had issues, that his mother had problems with him. In fact, one neighbor actually said that his mother was afraid of him. Others, including some of his friends, say no, he wasn't that kind of person and that he was just a normal guy. So this is another one of those confounding situations where you have a person who was on the radar of authorities there, purchased a gun legally, and still this slipped through the cracks here. And once again, we're talking about a tragedy.
Purchased the gun legally in California, too, right?
That's correct. In Simi Valley, a gun shop there, the Glock 21 45 caliber. But he also had an extended magazine that is already illegal in California. So he was able to get a hold of that. And again, we're going to be hearing more calls for these extended magazines and these high-capacity magazines to be really restricted.
And we're talking with Bill Zenfer, NBC News national correspondent, and the 12 people who were killed, including a law enforcement officer and a lot of young people who had just their entire lives ahead of them. What do we know about some of the victims, Bill?
Yeah, the victims have now been identified. And yeah, the stories are... None are more heart-wrenching than the story of the Ventura County Sheriff Sergeant Ron Helas, who was the first one there. He and a California Highway Patrolman arrived about the same time, and Helas charged into the scene and was shot and killed. A 29-year veteran of the Sheriff's Department, and it was a guy who was planning to retire in another year or two, and he leaves behind a family. There are many others, and of course, these were young people in here, as young as 18 years old, who had a full life in front of them, and these are just terrible stories we're hearing about. And it is the... Unfortunately, this year, now we've had this shooting, the Tree of Life Synagogue, of course, just a couple of weeks ago, Santa Fe High School, Parkland High School earlier this year, and here we are again.
Yeah, it's tough. Thank you, Bill. Great to have you on, as always. Bill Zenfer, NBC News national correspondent, latest on the shooter and what happened in Thousand Oaks, California. 12 people murdered, including Jason Kaufman's son. And, man... This is tough, but I mean, I think it's worth a listen to hear him talk right after learning essentially that his son was killed instantly in the latest mass shooting in the United States.
His name was Cody Kaufman, my firstborn son. Only him and I know how much I love. How much I miss him. Oh, God, this is so hard. Oh, son, I love you so much.
Just brutal. Absolutely brutal. 555 on WBAL.